إن شاء الله. طيب we're going to talk about the cure in 5 minutes, but let me tell you that story which I hope I can translate it right, just to show you that sometimes, because it's really part of the cure too, because I'm telling you, walking around and having paranoia about this subject is actually one of the worst things that you can do. So you're coming out of the house, man, I'm going to go to, they're going to say, should I take my children? Should I keep them at home? They're going to hit me. Actually, you're not supposed to pay attention to this at all. You're supposed to rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take the precautionary steps, which I will share with you, and leave the rest to who? Because nothing, ya ikhwa, befalls us except what? Allah wills. Will insan, the person who's innocent, I call him innocent, walking around with innocence in him, normally that Allah protects that person. Rasulullah SAW actually called him مَخْمُومُ الْقَلْبِ أَلَا أَذُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ كُلُّ مَخْمُومِ الْقَلْبِ. يعني the people would call him nowadays عبيط. عبيط, يقول لك عبيط, يعني the درويش. Actually those are the people that Allah saved from envy. We have one of those. القصة, there was a king, and he used to like this man so much, so innocent, Hajib. All what he likes to, whenever the king is sitting down, he would like this man to be seated next to him. One of the ministers of this king envied this man for his nearness, his position, being favored by the king. Subhanallah, every time this man would come to the court or to the room, where the king is sitting in his throne, he has him sit next to him, he would make that statement. كَفَى الْمُحْسِنُ إِحْسَانُهُ وَكَفَى الْمُسِيءُ إِسَاءَتُهُ. The muhsin, the good doer, his good doing will protect him. The evil doer, his evil will get to him. So the minister, like I said, had envy, burning jealousy inside him against this man. So he went to the king and he said to him, this man is circulating a rumor about you. What rumor? يقول أنك أبخر. He says, he's circulating the rumor that your mouth has a bad smell. You know, the person who is abkhar, some people, not only because of their mouth all the time, even when they use. So the king said to him, how can I verify that he's saying that? He said, next time when you talk to him, ask him to come closer to you. If he covers his mouth, then that's the evidence. And if he doesn't, then I will be held accountable for accusing him of something. Fine. He goes out of the room of the king and he invites this poor man to a meal. And he cooks garlic and onions for him. He had him eat what? Garlic and onion. So he came back to the room of the king. His mouth now, the man smells like what? So the king said to him, Udnu, Udnu, come closer to me. So in order not to offend the king, what did he do? He placed his hand where? قال صدق الوزير. He said the minister was right. ثم كتب كتابا. He said, go. Then he wrote a letter. And subhanAllah, it was one of the, who's waiting by the door, by the way? The minister. It was the tradition of this king that he never writes a letter A closed letter. You know one of these sealed letters? Accept with atiyah, accept with a grant. That's his history. He never wrote a letter with a harm. With harm, yani. يعني إذا كتب كتابا كان يكتب بعطية. If you get a letter from this king, that means you're gonna be what? This time he wrote in that letter, the bearer or the carrier of this letter, اقتلوا, kill him. ثم اسلخوا. You know what سلخ is? Separate his skin from his what? His body. ثم احشوا بطنه تبنا. Then stuff his belly with the straw and bring him back to me. So the man took the book and he's walking out. Who sees him? The minister. What is this? Kitab. No way. Kitab. The minister said, give me that book. Go ahead. He gave him the book. What is this? He's a humble man, you know, مخموم القلب. He doesn't have this. Okay, I'll take it to the person. So when he arrived, he opened the book and he looked at him and said, do you know what's in this book? He said, so and so. He said, that's not me, that's not. He said, no. راجع الملك. Go back to him. He said, no, كتاب الملك لا يراجع. This king, you cannot even go back to him. The process was done on him. So the man, the poor man entered and he, as soon as he entered, السلام عليك أيها الملك, السلام عليكم أيها الملك. And he said, كفى المحسن إحسانه وكفى المسيء إساءته. The محسن, his إحسان, his good doing, helped him. And he said, what are you doing here? He said, when I left the room, the minister took the book from me. So the king said, and by the way, this minister circulated a rumor about you that you were saying that my mouth has a bad smell. He said, I never said that. And he said, why did you place your hand in him? I said, because he invited me to eat onion and garlic. And I said, اجلس. He said to him, what? Sit down. كفى المحسن إحسانه وكفى المسيء إساءته. The good doer, his good doing what? What I'm trying to say from that story, Ikhwa, you can't be living with that paranoia out there. You can't. You cannot. Just do the right thing. Have the right attitude. Have reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seek the means in your power, in your authority, and leave the rest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا. Nothing will befall us, nothing will inflict us, unless what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills it. Quickly, Ikhwa, some of the things that we can do. By the way, evil eye, also jinn. There is an evidence in the sunnah that the jinn can give you the evil eye. Now, the way to protect yourselves from the jinn, evil eye, is what? Bismillah. When you take off your clothes, especially, Ikhwa, al-akhawat, sisters, for example, ستر عورات. When you say Bismillah, when you take off your clothes, a veil is placed on the eyes of the jinni. He doesn't look at you. Oh. The other thing, the famous, especially once it comes to our children, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kama fi Sahih Bukhari, he used to bring Al Hasan wal Husayn, and he used to say, "U'idukuma." We should do this to our children, ya ikhwa. If you're worried about your children before coming to the masjid, if you're concerned about your children before going out, why don't you make that dua for your children? أعيدكما بكلمات الله التام من كل شيطان وهام ومن كل عين لام. That's the dua. I seek refuge. It's very easy to remember, to memorize. I seek refuge on you, or refuge of Allah for you, by the virtue of the perfect words of Allah. من كل شيطان, from every demon, from every evil. هامة, scorpions. يعني this particular dua, by the way, one day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was in a desert. Imagine, a lot of us sometimes we go and camp someplace, and the companions came to me, يا رسول الله, there are scorpions and snakes in the desert. Say this dua. and go. If you say it to this, الهوام اللي هو scorpions, snakes, or any harmful insects, ومن كل عين لامة, and every evil eye. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do this in الحسن والحسين, and he used to say, كان أبوكما إبراهيم يعوذ بهما إسماعيل وإسحاق. Your grandfather Ibrahim used to make this دعاء on إسماعيل and إسحاق. Also يا إخوة, بسم الله, رقية النبي, رقية جبريل, the رقية of جبريل to النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. بسم الله أرقيك من كل شيء يؤذيك, من شر كل نفس أو عين حاسد الله يشفيك. بسم الله أرقيك من كل شيء يؤذيك, من شر كل نفس أو عين حاسد. دعاء like this, beautiful دعاء. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء. قل هو الله أحد. قل أعوذ برب الفلق. قل أعوذ برب الناس. Three times after Fajr, three times before Maghrib. All of these are adhkar, which are supposed to protect us, to help us. But I'm telling you, these adhkar are not going to work if you're not keeping up with the commands, if you're not praying five times, if you're not fulfilling the commands of Allah. It's not going to work if you're engaged in haram, disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In closing, ya ikhwa, if you get inflected and you know the person who evil-eyed you, there is no harm if you request their wudu water. And this is what the Prophet ﷺ did with Amir ibn Rabi'ah. He actually requested his wudu water, the story that I mentioned, and you go and shower with it or bathe with it, just in your body there is a way to do it. And by the way, if somebody, would you feel offended if somebody, would you feel offended if I come to you, Brother Waleed, can I have your wudu water, please? Huh? Would you feel offended? Salaamu alaykum, I'm asking you, seriously. Come on, answer me, would you feel offended? Suspicious. A lot of Muslims would feel offended, right? Why, you think I'm jealous, I'm envious? What is it? La, li, why? No problem. This is going to help you, brother. Go take my wudu water. Huh? How much? No, I'm just kidding. This is the subject of al-hasad, ya ikhwa. Nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yunajjiyana min al-hasad, ya rabbal alameen. I think above all, you and me should strive not to fall into that wicked characteristic of a heart. We always strive. If you see somebody having much better stuff than you have, if you see somebody having more successful life than what you have, say alhamdulillah. قدر الله وما شاء فعل, قضاء الله. يا رب, I'm happy, يا رب, with what you've given me. I'm going to strive to have. And if it doesn't happen, خلاص. I think that's the start. That for us, that you begin believing in قدر الله سبحانه وتعالى, قضاء الله وقدره بإذن الله تعالى. Secondly is try to protect yourselves. Try to protect yourselves. And I mentioned this yesterday في خطبة الجمعة, and we should mention it again. Don't try to ignite people's envy. يعني don't. If you know the person that he's sensitive about you, huh? And I use the example of Yaqub. Look at the beginning of the story. When Yusuf came to him and he said what? إذ قال يوسف لأبي, Yusuf said to his father what? يا أبتي, my father, I saw what? 11 stars and the sun and the moon doing what? What Yaqub said, what did he say to him? Why? Because he knows his brothers are what? Jealous. If you know that somebody out there is, especially with the sisters, by the way, I, with all due respect to our sisters, especially with the sisters, they love this. If they know that there is a sister who he very sensitive, oh, yakhti, you know what I have? My husband bought me this. My husband got me this. And I have this. And she goes around with the gold in front. Why, ya ukhti? Why? Don't ignite the evil forces inside the heart of your sister. Be careful. But at the same time, there is somebody out there that you know that he loves you. He would love for you to have a lot of goodness. Go ahead and tell it, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والحمد لله رب العالمين.